you were trying to come up with a list of teams as it stands right now, as we're about to approach February, that have a national title or bust mentality, which is to say, if they do not win the national championship, they will ultimately look back on this season as a failure. How many teams
failure might be strong, but go ahead.
Well, Well, then is it zero? I mean, because like last year, Gonzaga and Baylor were definitely on that list. Wouldn't you say? Like Gonzaga, the list was Gonzaga and Baylor. Like both of these teams, one of them's gonna have a. I mean, you know, you can sugarcoat as much as you want.
No, I'm gonna answer your question.
Yeah. So who would you put on that list,
Dan? I will answer your question.
Okay.
I think there are three teams, maybe four, that fit your criteria. Maybe five, and I'll explain.
Okay.
For sure, Gonzaga.
Yep.
Because they know this is it with Chet Holmgren and likely Drew Timmy. Okay. So this is title or bust. I think with UCLA, because all these guys came back.
Yep.
And they're not going to come back next year. So that's UCLA. That's two. I would say Kansas because of Abaji.
Yep.
And McCormack. And, you know, Remy Martin transfers there. So that's three that I would think it's like we got to win it or that's it. And I would also say that if you wanted to put Purdue in that,
I would.
Purdue, you know, with Travion Williams back, Zach Edey, I can't see him staying. Jaden Ivey's not going to stay. So this group built it up for it. So I put Purdue there. And then the other one that I would put in this grouping, but only because of it changed quickly, and that is Illinois, because they didn't think they were getting Kofi Coburn back.
Mm-hmm.
So like that wasn't their thinking, you know, in June. Okay. That he surprised everyone, A, when he withdrew from the draft and then came out of the portal.
Mm-hmm.
So getting Kofi back, you know, Curbelo had said he was going to stay, and obviously he's not been healthy, but, you know, Coburn, as you said, I mean, he changes everything with them, and that was not expected. So then once he comes back and everything starts going well, they're like, oh, wait a minute. Yeah, we could win the title.
Yeah.
So they're sort of on the fringe, and, you know, I'm hesitant to put Duke in there.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously Coach K and all that would want to do that, but as good as Boncaro is and can be, I think Wendell Moore, at least to the outside world, has been better than projected. Mm. And so I think they've become a more of a title contender, a little bit of a surprise that all, you know, Trevor Keels, AJ Griffin, all these pieces, as talented as they are, I'm not quite sure if you put truth serum in there that they thought they could actually win the championship.
Yeah.
And now they do.
Yeah. Mm. I think Duke has to be on there for the
I think if Coach K doesn't make the Final Four, he comes back.
I think if Coach K does not win a national championship this year, it tarnishes his entire legacy. I think it tarnishes his entire... I mean, I think you flush everything he's accomplished down the drain.
I know is this. John Wooden won a championship in his last year. That's all I know.
Hey there, thanks for watching Titus and Tate. For the full Friend of the Program experience, subscribe right below and come join us for all things college basketball. The action is heating up. Come join Titus and Tate.